My name is Lavanya Thamire. I'm the Director of Education at Kalanidhi Dance. I'm here with Pragna Thamire, our Kalanidhi company dancer. Namaste to all of you. This is how we greet each other in India. So let's try doing that together. Join your fingers together, bring your palms together, right in front of your chest, and take a bow. Namaste. Today, we're going to take you to the world of Indian classical dance and teach you Kuchipudi dance, which is one of the 8 Indian classical dance styles. Kuchipudi has been around for hundreds of years. It started in a small village called Kuchipudi in southern part of India, although today it's being danced all over the world.
What we are wearing today is a salwar kurta, which we usually wear when we practice dance. We dance barefoot, so if you're wearing any shoes, you should take them off right now. You may also notice the bells on our ankles. These bells create a noise that matches the beats in our music. While we are wearing a salwar kurta today, our costumes on stage are very different. We love bright colors and lots of jewelry. Here are a couple pictures of our dancers on stage in full costume. Now, before we begin to dance, we are going to do a namaskaram or a prayer step. To do a namaskaram, we thank the gods, our teachers, and we ask for forgiveness of Mother Earth for stomping on her.
Let's learn how to do the namaskaram together. So stretch your hands out, join your fingers together, like just like how we did for the when we greeted each other, join your palms together in front of your chest. And extend your hands to the side as you stretch your right leg forward. Bring your palms together on the top, thanking the gods. Bring your palms down in front of your forehead, thanking your teachers. And you're going to turn out and sit in a full squatting position, keeping your heels raised up, and you're asking for Mother Earth to forgive us for stamping on her. Let's do that to a count. Join your palms together for 1, 2, extend your hands to the side as you bring your right leg forward. 3, join your hands together. 4, bring your hands in front of your forehead. 5, turn out and sit in a full squatting position, keeping your heels raised up. And 6, 7, 8. Now that you've learned how to do namaskaram, let's learn how a little bit of Kuchipudi dance. We love telling stories through Kuchipudi dance. We do that by using our hand gestures, our footwork, and our facial expressions. Today, we are going to dance to a story called Elephant and the Crocodile. And in order to dance and teach you how to dance, we first have to learn how to become an elephant and how to become a crocodile. So let's learn how to become an elephant. What do we know about elephants? We all know that elephants have flapping ears and they have nice long trunks. So first, what hand gesture do we use to show the flapping ears? This is called langula. The way to do that is bring your left hand, place it in front of you. Make sure that your elbow is raised up in line with your shoulder. Bend your ring finger halfway down. Now place the left hand by your left ear. And to show the flapping ears, let's turn the wrist out, palm facing outward, and your palm facing back in towards you. Let's turn the wrist out and in. Does this feel like the elephant's ears flapping? I hope so. So now let's do that to a count. Let's go 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Wonderful. Now, in order to show the trunk, we use Dola Hasta. Stretch your right hand out, slightly bend at your elbow, and bring your ring finger and your middle finger slightly inwards. Now, we know that elephants have beautiful trunks. And so to show that, bring your Dola Hasta in and take it to the right top diagonal and slightly relax your wrist. Let's try that. Bring the hand in and up and in and up. Let's do that to a count. 1, 2, 3, 4. And 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Excellent. Now, let's put the flapping ears and the trunk together and see how that feels. So, do you remember that Langula Hasta, where you stretch your fingers and bend your ring finger halfway down, and the Dola Hasta, bring your right hand by your ear and let's go 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1, 2, 3, 4 1, 2, 3, 4 Wonderful. Now that you've learned how to show an elephant with your hand gestures, the next step is how do we put in footwork and learn to do the elephant walk or the elephant gait. One, two, three, four, and 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4. So let's learn how to do that. Let's go back. So let's start with our right leg, just like how we take a step forward. But we need to bend our left knee as we take the step. So let's go bend the knee and take the step. Now bend your right leg, just take the step. And go 1 and 2. And 1 and 2. And 1 and 2. Excellent. Let's try that one more time. Now let's go 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. That is actually called a swing walk, and it's a Kuchipudi walk that we do. Now that you've learned that, let's put our hands together and see how it feels to do the elephant walk. Left hand by your ear, right hand in Dola Hasta. And take the hand in. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Wonderful. You learn how to become an elephant. So, but we also need to learn how to become the crocodile. What do we know about crocodiles? Crocodiles are low to the ground, they are very sneaky, and they have long snouts and sharp teeth to catch their prey. So the hand gesture that we use to show a crocodile is called Makara Hasta, and this is how it looks. Now let's learn how to do that. Bring both your hands out, make sure that there's a lot of energy in the fingers, and you fold your index finger halfway through and your ring finger. Now join both your hands together at the wrist, and in order to show the jaw opening and closing, you're going to slowly take the right hand down and up and down and up and down and up. Let's try that one more time. Elbows up, fingers stretched. Bend the index finger halfway and your ring finger. Now join your hands at the wrist and show the teeth. 1, 2, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Wonderful. Let's try to add the footwork to show the crocodile crawling. We need to go down using a deep lunge. Let's try to do that. So let's start with the left leg and go down and drop the left knee down and go all the way to your right and drop the right knee down. Go all the way to your left, drop the left knee down, and all the way right, drop the right knee down. Good, let's try that one more time. Let's try and go, see if we can go down with our upper body as we go down deep. So let's go down and bend. Go down as you move to your right, and down as you move to your left, and down as you move to your right. Great. Now let's put the hand gestures together that we learned for the crocodile as we show the crocodile. So let's start. Going to the left and add the facial expressions. The elephant is searching for its prey. And look around. It's sneaking slowly. And then it waits. Once it finds its prey, it waits for the right moment and with a quick move, attack. Now that you've learned how to become a crocodile, we're going to tell you the story of the elephant and the crocodile. So, one hot summer day, an elephant decides to wander in the forest and it comes across the lake. It suddenly starts feeling hot and is bothered by the heat. So, he decides to go take a shower in the waters. So, let's teach them actually how to take a shower in the water with the elephant. I think we didn't do that earlier. So, you all learn how to show the trunk and the flapping ears. So when the elephant finds the lake, the elephant uses the trunk to scoop the water, pick up the water, scoop it up and shower itself. Let's do this again. Use the trunk, pick up the water and scoop it up and shower. See how happy the elephant is? Because it's having a great time. And scoop it up and shower itself. So, as the elephant was showering and feeling better, the poor elephant was unaware of the fact that there was a hungry crocodile very close by watching to catch its prey. And the crocodile waits, plans its attack, and with a quick move grabs the elephant's leg. The elephant is in great pain. Elephant tries very hard to escape from the crocodile's clutches. The elephant tries to drag its foot back and forth, but the crocodile's clutches are so strong that it is too hard for the elephant. So they go back and forth, and they both get very tired and are not ready to give up. But luckily for the elephant, a hunter who is passing by strikes the crocodile and relieves the elephant. The elephant thanks the hunter for saving him. So that's how the story goes. So there's a small part where we did the footwork that we'd like to teach it to you. How the battle between the elephant and the crocodile So the first position in which we dance is called Aramandi, where we turn out our toes and knees and we go into a half sitting position, which is called Aramandi. Let's try that again. The turnout comes from the hips. So back straight in your nice postures, all of you, and turn out your toes and sit half. And now, if you saw, we used another foot position called Kunchitam. This is Kunchitam. And we also used Anchitam. So let's try how we can do Kunchitam. Kunchitam is when you raise, press your legs on your toe mounts and raise your heels up. So that's Kunchitam. And Anchitam is when you press your legs on your heels. Good job. So how do we move back and forth when the elephant and crocodile were fighting and when the elephant was desperately trying to release itself from the crocodile's clutches? Let's try and do that to a count. So turn out position and you go, let's do that, try to the beat. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So if you see, it almost feels like you're walking on your toe marks. 2, 3. And then pressing your heel down. Now, let me be the elephant and Pragna will be the crocodile and try the movement. Are you all ready? Take your left hand by your ear and right hand into the dolahasta. And anyone who wants to be the crocodile can follow Pragna. And let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Also, notice the face, the expressions in the face. The elephant is in great pain. And the crocodile is so happy and ready to eat the elephant or have its lunch or whatever. So let's try that. Let's go. Let's try that again. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now that you heard the story, we would like to dance it and show how it looks when we dance it to the music. How it looks when we dance it to the music. We are very thankful that we got a chance to teach you a little bit of Kuchipudi. We thoroughly enjoyed teaching it to you. I hope you all loved learning it. Thank you so much for having us, and we hope to see you all very soon in person. Thank you. Namaste.